In Brooklyn, I'd be waiting a whole week to play pickup soccer again at Prospects Park's turf. I just wish there were more pickup games outside my club practices growing up. Look at kids these days, practicing, being coached, they don't get to express themselves or even dare to try something new. I don't think soccer in America is actually structured that way though. I don't know if kids that play club football will ever have time for pickup games.
Para su información, nuestro tiempo estimado de vuelo a la Ciudad de México será de 3 horas con 5 minutos. Estaremos volando a una altitud promedio de 13.500 metros sobre el nivel del mar.
My name is Travis Forsythe, a Guyana-born American. I'm known as iTechers on Instagram and currently playing semi-pro soccer in the US. I'm traveling to Mexico City with World Soccer Shop and Howlo Magazine to discover local soccer. Mexico City is the capital of a soccer-crazed country, and each time El3 has made it into the World Cup. But how are they able to perform so consistently? So on our first day, we're taking some time to get acclimated to Mexico City. My first impression? It's a very busy city, which reminds me of Brooklyn, but people are more friendly. And oh, not to mention the food. I'm already enjoying the best tacos over here. As we roam around the inner city, we came across a few parks and found that they all have courts for soccer. Many are for soccer specifically, while others share with sports like basketball. It's around lunchtime during a weekday when we started noticing middle-aged men gathering in the middle of the park. All of a sudden, backpacks were dropped, teams were picked. I had to jump in. That was fun. It was a great warm-up. I'm not hungry for more. Morretas. That's what locals call competitive pickup games. We hopped around the city, discovering different parks until late in the day. Then we realized we were really close to a sketchy area, so we decided to get out. We later found out the area was called Topito, a neighborhood famous for its black markets and crime, but also home to one of Mexico's national team legend, Cuauhtémoc Blanco. The next day, we decided to hit up a local park here where we spotted people playing. I jumped on the court to play a little five-a-side with the locals. I spotted this Maradona-looking light player with a strong left foot. His name was Jurgen, a truck driver by day, a rapper by night, and in between, play soccer. After the session, we asked him about where we could find more games. Jurgen invited us to play with his friends at a local university nearby.
Ahorita vamos hacia el parque de mi squad. Vamos a jugar. Unas retas.
Improviso mientras al ritmo que pateo el balón. Para toda la gente que me ve el día de hoy, quizá me graban creando, componiendo una canción. Mientras improviso al momento de meto el gol. Lo mío es fútbol, quizá arte a la cancha. Aunque a mis anchas me desplazo en el momento, yo solamente siento y doy el ancho cuando voy goleando a la gente que me avalancha. Esta buena rima aquí nunca se para, como el mejor goleador llegando a casa. Si juegan de local y ganan aunque...
A question I get asked a lot is what does football mean to me. For me, it's just personally a way to express how I really feel in other ways I can express or explain in words. These guys right here, they're really gonna show me what football means to them.
En este país no tiene que haber una cancha para que se juegue fútbol. Dos piedras o dos mochilas y un balón y a veces hasta una botella. Solamente se ocupa un espacio y que la gente quiera jugar fútbol. Yo opino que es un poco más a la cultura, cómo se, la manera en la que se crece, la manera en la que te educan tus papás. Es un símbolo de este país, la gente es... El fútbol es un deporte que al menos en este país se mueve a todo.
Jurgen seems to know where the spots are, so I figured I'd ask him for advice on where we can find raw soccer spots in town. He recommended that we visit Alvaro Obregón, one of the most populated barrios in Mexico City. Jurgen cautioned us to leave before dark. Before we head out to Alvaro Abrigón, we wanted to visit our friends at Love Football Mexico, an organization that helps build safer places to play for undeserved youths in countries like Brazil and Japan. The particular Love Football location called Cuilito works to develop young leaders to help run football-related workshops. Love Football helps rebuild and maintain courts while training young leaders to manage the community. Despite the makeup of the neighborhood around it, Cuilito has been a safe haven for children to play.
Yo siento que como que el fútbol está en todos los corazones de los mexicanos. Algunos muy profundo y otros así, a la luz de todos.
Es una pasión para los mexicanos porque es un deporte sano y que si todos lo hicieran no tendríamos tantos problemas.
Donde todos se emocionan más es cuando ves cuando corren por el balón, cuando meten gol y pues la gente se emociona.
Cuando México ganó contra Alemania, todos los mexicanos se pusieron como más emocionados con el fútbol.
Llega Hernández, Hernández contra Boateng, la dejan para Lozano, está el primero. Lozano engancha, Lozano el primero, Lozano gol.
Jürgen had warned us about Alvaro Abrigón, but we really wanted to experience it before we leave Mexico City.
You could definitely tell that is more of a rough area that we're actually heading into right now.
O sea, ellos van a notar que no eres de por ahí. Entonces, tienes que tener ya ciertas precauciones. Ya cuando empiece a oscurecer o que empiece a llover, pues hay que salirse.
After hitching rides, wandering around, we ended up in what's supposed to be the center of football for the people in Alvaro Abrigón. Locals said twice a year, this field hosts some of the biggest tournaments that gathers teams from across various barrios. It feels like an oasis compared to what we saw on our journey here. The turf field hides in the valley and shows it's been worn down over the years. Despite its condition, it's a safe place kids can come out and play after school and on the weekends.
Like today's society in America, whereby everybody just wants to stay in the house and just play Fortnite. You know what I mean? It's really different in these type of areas. Everybody want to be outside.
It's amazing that even in the barrios, football is available and keeps the community connected.
I'm already feeling this longing inside. Knowing a soccer back home in Brooklyn isn't as accessible if you don't have the means to pay.
I'm not an expert at this, but the fact that Mexico has accessibility and a safe place to play, no matter the neighborhood, rich or poor, the fact that kids can come out and freely play and make mistakes outside the time they spend developing skills with their club. Maybe this is how Mexico produces technical players that are more comfortable in the ball and have more creativity. Maybe that's how Mexico had the edge over the USA in making the World Cup. Maybe, just maybe, cero a dos.
Howler Magazine, yo les tengo que decir muchas gracias por patrocinar y por hacernos venir hacia una cancha para poder convivir con toda la gente que vive aquí en el barril, para poder jugar un poquito de fútbol, crear y vivir, sentir toda la emoción. Vivimos con la gente, compartimos la afición, un amor que nos une y el lenguaje es el fútbol.